Welcome back to Ucypher and Sport, Nice Superstars. Final game of the day. This can turn tables completely. I'm talking about DOTA 2.
Welcome back to Ucypher. Sherdils will take on the Yakshas today.
I was practicing my backstroke.
Is the Radiant ban?
Dire's ban now.
Ten seconds left by my count. 5 seconds remaining. Radiant's turn to ban.
The Dire get a ban. Seconds.
5 seconds remaining. Turn to ban.
Dire's turn to pick.
Radiant's turn to pick.
Slada.
Radiant's turn to pick.
Crystal Maiden.
Seconds.
I understand Doom is good and all that, but TZ is still first phase material. I'm not too sure.
Yeah, I'm not convinced by this Doom ban out either. It's something that can be saved for a later stage in the draft. I don't think any team is going to go first picking the Doom here. But Yakshas are going to open up with an old school duo. The Crystal Maiden and the Queen of Pain are going to come out here.
Yeah.
That's some good mana regeneration coming out for that middle lane co-op. You can have yourself
seconds.
That Stream of Pain on pretty much at the ready every time you
Five
want it. That's going to make
remaining.
Pushing the lane pretty easy for the Yakshas lineup on the middle lane at least, which should in turn secure them the runes. Sherdils though, they've got what it takes to contest the runes. They've got the Slara who excels at moving about in the river now, courtesy the new changes to Sprint.
Yeah.
So contesting the runes should be something that Sherdils will be looking to do early to mid in
Is
this game.
The
but they're going to supplement Disruptor. That Slara pick with the Disruptor as their secondary
Dire's
support, and I think they've just
now.
Shown us their hand in terms of their 4 and 5 position already.
Mm-hmm. I like the Disruptor pick. It's some form of lockdown versus the Queen of Pain, and if she does hope to retreat after probably securing a couple of kills in a fight, you can always glimpse her back. You've got the Static Storm at the ready. Slaughter is nice as well. One of the interesting changes to Crystal Maiden is a level 15 talent, which is 14% mana cost reduction order. I mean, as a Crystal Maiden, you almost always want to pick up a GPM talent, but 14% mana cost reduction is a lot when you have somebody that's very dependent on mana, something like the co-op, something like the Storm.
But you know, what's as confusing as the... what's even more confusing though is that Crystal Maiden's level 20 talent is a choice between plus 60 freezing field damage
remaining.
Or 250 attack speed.
Yeah.
How is that even a choice?
I don't know. But there is one player in India who would really be considering the latter and finding a way to make that work, and that's... I'm not going to take names. That's Deliverance though. There's someone he always wants to be a clown in Dota. I think Ice Frog and the rest of Valor decided, like, let's just make this game more Sing Sing friendly. What can we do so that Sing Sing can have an entertaining stream? Give 200 attack speed
and
to Crystal
a
Maiden.
Hero that looks like the Beaver Knight himself. How much more of a tribute can you give to Sing Sing himself? But I like this. Yakshas go with the Undying. He is a real pain to deal with in this meta. I'm referring, of course, to the talent where he drops a tombstone upon death, and of course the other talent where he gets a reincarnation. Mm-hmm. So Wraith King has a competitor here, the Undying. But They're going to go with the Visage on the side of Sherdils. Lots of physical damage coming out in addition to that armor reduction from the Slaughter. You're going to have those familiars pounding away on a target. Armor reduction and physical DPS is one way to go versus that Undying, no doubt. But,
I mean, you've also got the familiars to target the Tombstone, which is going to help pick down the Tombstone.
It's a pretty smart pick coming out from Sherdils. Disruption has done his homework. I mean, he's probably studied the patch and recognized that Undying would be hot stuff, and they're going to play to their own strengths and pick up that Visage. We've seen them run this before as well.
I'm sensing a Medusa pick here from the Yakshas.
She has been hot stuff with other teams at least. And there it is. You called it, man. Medusa comes out for the Yakshas.
So I said this because Acrid did play Medusa in his previous game. There is some synergy between the Crystal Maiden and the Medusa, and when you pick up a hero like the Undying, I also get the feeling that Yakshas, on the basis of that Undying pick, are going to try and run some sort of aggressive tri lane early on.
You know, that said, I feel like this might be a good game for Sherdils to pick up the Anti-Mage for themselves. There's not too many sources of lockdown on the side of Yakshas. I mean, they have just one last pick who's going to be an offlaner, I assume, unless there's an offlane Undying. Undying's got no lockdown. Crystal Maiden, sure, she's got the roots. That's one lockdown that she has to get in really close for. And it's something that can be dealt with when you get a Lincoln Sphere. No, never mind. You can actually deal with the Frostbite with a Lincoln Sphere, right?
Yeah.
So I don't feel like Yakshas has enough to stop an Anti-Mage in his tracks this early on. Sherdils should consider picking it up. In fact, just picking it up right off the bat here doesn't seem like a bad idea either. They're going to go with the Weaver.
Okay.
Another possible Diffusal Blade candidate. Another candidate that loves to abuse the fact that there's a lack of lockdown.
It's a great game for the Weaver. Yakshas, they've got to carry a lot of detection. There's going to be a Weaver that's mobile and running around battle. They're going to be the familiars, which are a nuisance in themselves. It's going to be a hard game for a Crystal Maiden early on.
You bet it is. And again, more armor reduction being thrown upon that Slara's amp damage with the Weaver and the Swarm. So.
And it might also be a game where the Visage builds a Solar Crest.
Yeah, why not?
In addition with that Axe.
And then even the Medusa looks squishy, man.
Yaksha's last ban, possibly looking to ban out one of Khan's heroes. Both the Darkseer as well as the Beastmaster, two of his stronger heroes, have been ignored until this point. And I think we could see the Yakshas ban out either one. We do know that Khan's played a phenomenal Darkseer the last time around between Sherdils and the Akramaks. He was fantastic.
Phenomenal is an understatement. It's really an understatement. It's not doing justice to him. If I wasn't engaged, I'd make babies with Khans after that game. He was just fantastic on the Darkseer.
Yeah, I saw some of his plays, and for the first time in my life, and I'm lying about the first time in my life, but I felt really guilty that we didn't do justice to how good Khans played in that game. He played some really phenomenal DOTA, and all of Sherdils as a team looked really good in the last engagement. But look at this, Yakshas, they're banning out the Invoker.
I left scratching my head, because this looks like it's pretty straightforward, right? We're going to look at Visage going mid.
Yeah.
And this should be a four position Slaughter. I doubt we're going to see Khans playing a three position Slaughter here. I'm still a fan of the Darkseer for him this game. I think it's going to add a fair bit of value. You've got the Crush with the Vacuum. You've got the Static Storm on top of the Vacuum. These are things that Sherdils lineup has practiced and you know it. So I'd like to see them pick up the Darkseer here. There's also that bit of synergy with the Weaver that comes in the early game. The Ion Shell with an Invis Hero scurrying about. It can prove to cause some problems here for Yakshas. Sherdils, last ban on the board before they move into their final pick as well. It's going to be a Bloodseeker ban coming out. Not a bad ban at all versus the Weaver, but that would imply that Yakshas were looking at an offlane Bloodseeker, which seems improbable to say the least. Fifth and final pick for Sherdils. I'd still like to see the Darkseer. My money's on the Darkseer, but unfortunately I have none, so I'm probably going to be proven wrong anyway.
5 seconds remaining.
I still think we're going to see a Darkseer or possibly a Beastmaster. I'm leaning more towards the Beastmaster. That's what the Earthshaker ban indicates to me.
I do agree with the Beastmaster because Necrobooks would be nice as well. What?
Okay, so it's an offlane Slaughter.
Or an offlane Weaver. No, it should be an offlane Slaughter. That's unconventional to say the least, but it's effective versus Medusa. And it's not too shabby versus the co-op at mid. Good work.
OD versus Pop.
What'll it be?
You've also got to remember the synergy with the OD and heroes like the Disruptor or the Slada, right? Good setup with the Astral Imprisonment, drop a Static Storm on top of it, the Cop's going nowhere. Yeah. Likewise with the Medusa, no Stone Gaze follow-up confirmed. Mm-hmm. Good setup for the middle laning stage as well, in the early stages of the game. With the Slada rotating in with the movement speed. Let's see what Yakshas has though. Because this seems like a curveball that's been thrown at them, one that they may not have a sufficient response for. Do you go for a wacky pick like the Pugna here? Then maybe run the Pugna in the offlane and ensure yourself a fair bit of damage with that Nether Ward. No, you go with Tinker instead. Apparently it's going to be an offlane Queen of Pain and a mid Tinker. Both sides running some very unconventional drops here. Not the likes that we've seen before.
So I still think we're going to see an aggressive play coming up from Yaksha, safe lane Queen of Pain, mid Tinker, and this does mean that there's one thing that the Yakshas excel at, and that's holding high ground. Mm-hmm. But they've got to get off with that good start in the laning phase, and time and time again, we've seen many Indian teams try to run an aggressive tri lane and they fail.
Yeah.
It's a very hit and miss. It takes a lot of communication between your two supports. Let's see if Funk and the Endike and VP and the Crystal Maiden do have that within them.
They're going to be up against a Visage tri lane though, and that's just
Visage
suicide.
Just excels at tri lanes.
That's suicide. You don't want to go up against a hero that gets stronger with more attacks being thrown about on the battlefield.
I think we're both wrong. We're seeing an offlane Visage here because Khans is the offlaner for Sherdils.
Okay.
Unless they're switching things up.
It's very likely they're going to switch once more because an offlane Visage doesn't seem to be a very tempting proposition.
No.
Especially when there's confirmed lockdown on the other side. But I mean, the Visage probably won't die in that lane because VP shouldn't have enough lockdown versus the Visage to ensure that he dies with just an Undying and an Acrid Medusa over there.
I mean, so even Sherdils know that something's not right in the lane with that Tinker pick. They know that the Yakshas are looking for rather unconventional lanes, and I'm hoping for two things for both teams to start off with. An early magic stick, and whoever gets the vision advantage early on is going to win that lane. The side lanes are going to be so crucial. I mean, whoever plants that early ward before the other has so much more information to work with. And
wait,
Mamacita,
what?
He's accusing Valve of not giving him a teleport scroll. Gabin, we pay for battle passes and you can't give us a teleport scroll?
How does that even happen? How does that even happen, man?
That shouldn't be happening. Okay. So...
okay, we're gonna remake because the game bugged out apparently. Let's wait for an official word from the admins about what we're doing here.
It's also interesting to note that Yakshas have VP playing the 5 position. VP usually plays the 4 position. Last time he was phenomenal on the clockwork. This time around he's playing the 5 position while Punk is playing the Undying.
Does this happen because they swap heroes about or something? We can throw our DP. I like this, if that seems fair. Why not? Someone throw a TP and make it
just
even.
Just drop your TP and break it.
I mean, the equivalent hero on the other side should throw it. So if Visage is playing...
but okay, Visage never mind. Okay. Mamacita is a bigger man. And
50 gold doesn't mean squat to this man.
Yeah.
He's here to win 50 legs.
Find a snack.
Alright Vivek, quick predictions, who's going to take this one? The last Medusa Sherdils pick wasn't so successful. Okay, you're going to go with Sherdils again, so not really riding on the Medusa wave just yet. You don't think Medusa has got what it takes to hold this game, take it back? We know for a fact that Sherdils are going to come through the gates charging in the first 15 minutes, right? The question is, will Yakshas be able to hold them off? They've got the Tinker to hold a potential push, they've got the Medusa to hold a potential push. Maybe, just maybe, they'll be able to do what their opponents in the early game couldn't.
Mm-hmm. I mean, Punk has said this time and time again that many Indian teams, the moment they're up against a Tinker who has BOT's Blink, maybe a Kaya or an Aether Lens, they just struggle to breach high ground against them. But we've seen Sherdils as one of the better teams here at the Ucypher Season 1 when it comes to breaching high ground. They've done it successfully versus the Akramaks. It was difficult back then, and I think Sherdils can do it once more. With the Familiars, with the Weaver, they might be able to break down the enemy's defense. But Rival scouts out the aggressive try.
This is working in their favor because it's not a visage in the defensive try lane versus Yaksha's aggro try. This aggro try could now work for the Yakshas, and if it works,
because they're
it
not up against the Visage.
I mean, that only means that Medusa is going to get a good start in the early game, and Weaver's not going to get such a good one. Mm-hmm. Anyway, in the jungle, Khalnaya keeps trying for the bounty rune, but Disruption is going to take it away in his face. Fortune. He is a safe lane Queen of Pain, by the way, so that's. He's got one thing working for him. However, he's going to be up against Khans and occasionally Disruption, so that could still be difficult. One of the major problems of running the safe lane Queen of Pain is you don't really have that unlimited mana courtesy the bottle, right? You can't rely on going to the runes to pick up the rune and replenish your mana. You will eventually run out of mana for Shadow Strikes and possibly Screams of Pains to push out the wave. That's when the Visage could just stand his ground, man fight, and possibly even throw out a couple of counter soul assumptions.
But do you want to push out the wave?
You probably don't want to push out too far, but you do want to push occasionally in case the Visage pulls from the side camp, right?
Yeah.
Because if that happens, then you're going to end up with a creep wave going to his tower by default, in which case you probably want to push even harder to get that tower taken apart earlier on. Problem is, none of this works without rotations coming in from the Crystal Maiden or the Undying, who honestly are going to have their hands full on the top lane. Even with an Undying rotating towards the bottom lane, I don't think the Visage dies. A Gravekeeper's Cloak. It'll work wonders to keep him alive. Not really sure why we have another pause. Mamacita says Mike, but yeah, I would have assumed that Mike issues would have been sorted out by now.
Odie versus Tinker. Thoughts on that matchup? I think it's one that a skilled Odie can win. I mean, laser irritates you, but you can use Astral to secure a couple of denies for yourself.
That's a lane that really boils down to this Observer God, right? And Odie's job in this lane, while he's most likely going to get a fair bit of CS in the lane, his job is to just stay alive till he maxes out the Astral Imprisonment. And then you can do that cheesy trick where you imprison one creep, hit a couple of auto attacks on the others, and the entire wave just disappears. That's guaranteed lane push, guaranteed farm for yourself, and you do it from a fairly safe distance as well.
Mm-hmm. For some reason, my DOTA is bugging out. And just
going
quickly.
Yeah, that happens occasionally. You simply got to reconnect to the game and the ghost pointer goes away. But you have time.
Your thoughts on the draft? I mean, who do you think...
Who are you
leaning towards in this game?
Sherdils. I think they've got the better draft here. They've got... I mean, they check most of the boxes in my book, right? Initiation with Slada / Disruptor, physical DPS with the Weaver and the Slada, defensive measure with the OD, and tower takedown potential with the Visage. I think they've got a fairly good lineup going for them. The only thing I'm worried about for Sherdils is that they cannot let this game go on for too long. Because Tinker's gonna be aiming to take this game for as long as he possibly can.
Yeah.
It doesn't look like there's a natural Hood of Defiance builder on the side of Sherdils. That's gonna make pushing into the March very difficult. To put it very simply, I think I want to say either it's a 30-minute victory for Sherdils or a 70-minute one for Yakshas.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's going to be hard for the Yakshas to try and end this game soon. I like how Yakshas are leaning. I mean, they've got late-game security. At the same time, they're running an aggressive try lane with the Medusa. There is a lot of kill potential between the Medusa, the Undying, and the Crystal Maiden. Even if you just leave the Medusa by herself after she gets a good start, it's going to be harder and harder for Weaver to approach that lane. But if this game goes on a bit, I mean, if Slada picks up his Blink, if maybe Vista just has a couple of levels, along with that Amplify damage and the Swarm coming out from the Weaver, they have more than enough to deal with the Medusa later on.
And like you said, eventually they're going to go for the Fusil on that Weaver.
Yeah.
So that's just the cherry on top.
Couple of difficulties up there on the main stage. Apparently, mic issue, if I'm not mistaken, the players are good to go, but Mamacita still trying to get his mic issues sorted out. What's vision looking like? So the Radiant, I mean, new map, new terrain. I'm always curious to see what teams are prioritizing in terms of vision. So the Radiant have got this rather unconventional ward. It does scout the bounty rune, but I mean, when you're running an aggressive try and enemy supports might be flanking you from the side, they really don't have too much vision to work with on the sides. The Dire, though, they have prioritized this mid ward, and you did mention how crucial it is in the Tinker versus OD matchup. It seems as if Sherdils have got a slight head start here. Who's holding on to the second observer on the side of... what? Where's the other Radiant Observer? Is there only one Radiant
only
Observer?
One.
Is Tinker... Has he planted it? Am I missing something?
Let me double check this real quick.
Is there an observer on the courier?
Well, I think there's one still available in stock.
Okay. Huh.
Okay, never mind. You can't really tell if it's in stock or not.
Yeah.
Courier maybe? Nope, not on the courier either. This is a first.
This is a first. I mean, Mamacita didn't get a TP, but you still get two wards, I'm pretty sure about that.
Someone cheaped out here on this.
Yeah, someone cheaped out. It's not really important. I mean, you want Punk to get levels, but items would be nice, but that's not what you're relying on to win in the mid game. Just getting EXP, getting those insane talents up and going. This is real talents clicking. Okay, Mamacita's got his headphone back on.
Okay, that took a while, but we're good to go finally.
Way anchor. This
not
game
really
is
sure
on.
What the issue was. No one ever tells casters anything, but...
Nope.
Fair enough. Game's back underway. Rival and Acrid will be beating it out at level 1. The bounty runes, the contest is over. And the lanes have now revealed themselves.
Mm-hmm.
It is an offensive try lane up top, where Acrid, Punk and VP will be holding the fort. With a sentry ward placed dab smack in the center of the lane to deal with Rival. A frost, no, crystal nova instead of the frostbite. I don't know if that was the best choice.
I think crystal nova. Yeah, I'm trying to find reasoning for this. The frostbite is a root, it's great versus the weaver. It could secure a kill. But look at this. Rival, I'm not sure he knows that there's a sentry. Now he does because Acrid attacked him.
Yeah, no sentry ward available for the disruptor. None for disruption either. This is going to get complicated. Disruptor and disruption.
I think we'll just call them Slada and Disruptor henceforth.
Mamacita on the middle lane is... has he got an ACS rolling? He's got 2 and 3. So Tinker's at 3 and 0. They're going eye for an eye right now. But now it's a party at the top lane. A tri lane versus a tri lane. And the magic sticks, or rather the full magic wand, has been purchased by Acrid already.
Mm-hmm.
So he's prepped and ready to fight this.
I think we can leave our camera here for the next 30 seconds and we'll find out who's going to get off to a good start. Disruption, there's no way he man fights Punk this early on. They're going to need Rival to hit level 2, which he has, and I hope he's put a point into the swamp on the Weaver.
So, interestingly enough, Rival's intentionally pushed out the wave here, and that means that Acrid's not going to get the best CS under his own tower, while Rival's actually walking forward and just CSing like no one's business. This is not the way an offensive tri lane is run. He's out here by himself, his supports are far off on the side. There should be decay spams, there should be attempted roots on him, there should be attempted auto attacks on him. You're not really zoning out the enemy off the enemy core and you're not really accomplishing much yourself. VP, he actually took more damage than he dished out over there, going in for that one crystal nova. He just walked through a bunch of creeps to get it done.
That's not very efficient.
Meanwhile, that made. We talked about the crush setup courtesy of the Astral Imprisonment. It's gonna come out now. Appa turns around, but the rockets will be soaked up by the illusions. And because of that, disruption will just barely survive.
I mean, this is good news for Sherdils here. I think Weaver, as well as Disruptor, can happily deal with the Crystal Maiden and the Medusa. Sherdils, they're just going to win because the Crystal Maiden is pretty much awful all by herself. They force the Undying rotation, and now Punk just makes his way back to the top lane.
Yeah, Acrid's hitting pretty hard though this early on.
Yeah.
Early magic sick and the early stats coming out from the circulator to give him a fair bit of auto attack damage. And he's really bringing the pain to both Rival and Opa, but the problem is they're spamming so many spells, not really committing to a kill, while the Weaver's under regen courtesy that Iron Branch Tango that came out. Now she's got 12 charges, but she doesn't use them! How can you make a rookie mistake like that? You knew the sentry ward was there.
That was uncharacteristic. That shouldn't be happening. He had stick charges around 10, 12 charges, and he doesn't end up using them.
Oh, but a casual 125 gold goes over to Opa for denying that tombstone, by the way.
I hope he picks up a stick himself. Top lane, they're going in. VP needs to be careful. Disruption looking for the angle. Punk moves over to the side. Both teams working with very little vision in this part of the map. Opa walks in, takes a DK. Khans is rotated. I really like this adjustment coming out. Khans is going to do a lot better than the Weaver. And I mean, this pretty much puts an end to all the aggression coming out from the Yakshas.
Yeah.
You overcommit, you're going to take a soul assumption. And Khans is coming with a lot of levels. He's actually coming into this lane with a significant advantage.
Yeah, he's the most level hero in this trial lane right now. But
yeah.
One thing that's upsetting me is that Acrid chose not to pick up an early Basilius in this lane. Giving Punk that mana to continue spamming alongside the Crystal Maiden regeneration would have been absolutely devastating. Here.
Yeah, one of them needs it. I guess Acrid will pick it up next.
Rival ends up scoring a solo kill versus Khalnayak and then he drops to the Shadow Strike. Okay. But that works out for Rival. He got the EXP from that kill. Meanwhile, mid as well, looks like Mamacita was in a bit of trouble himself. Akka going in with what looks to be a fair bit of mana and HP. He's gone in with 3 points in the Heat Seeking Missile and 2 in the Laser, so he's not prioritizing farm, he's using the fight.
Tribute.
That could come back to hurt him when the push decides to come through from Sherdils.
So when do you want to start putting points in the March, if you're on the Tinker?
In this game, you probably do it as early as you can and just rely on farming the jungle to get your BOTs.
Okay.
While he is doing well for now, that lead could very well be eroded with another good rotation from the Slaughter. Punk and VP though, just asserting their dominance. This is like a dog that's marking his territory by going into the enemy dog's home and peeing on it. They're just standing behind the tier 1 tower and ensuring that Khans can't come forward.
But Sherdils are okay with this. I mean, they're okay with Khans getting what he can while they're prepping for a play in the mid lane. The Slaughter is here. The mid ward should be timing out around this point. In fact, Tinker doesn't even have one.
He has one. Mom. It's right.
Okay,
that,
I missed it.
That ward even showing him anything because it's down on the lower step. This doesn't even look up slope.
I don't think it looks up high ground, yeah.
That's the most useless ward I've ever seen in Dota.
Disruption moving from rune to rune.
Soldier's fortune.
I mean, we're going to see soon enough if that buff to Slaughter and his movement in the river is going to ensure a quicker blink dagger. 6 minutes in, he's sitting at 800 gold, which isn't too bad. I mean, he's just holding on to bare essentials here, but not done too bad for himself.
Acrid's farming really well though in the top lane, but there's going to be a casual grave chill thrown out upon him. No real initiations coming out from the rest of Sherdils. Punk just delivering a warning shot here with that decay. Trying to keep Khans at bay. Meanwhile, Opa's inside the jungle here on the Radiant side of the map. This could prove to be troublesome for him. Or rather, prove to be troublesome for Appa on the middle lane. But between the OD and the Disruptor, they just don't have enough to bring down that Tinker. He did choose to put 1 point into the Arcane Orb, so he has a fair bit of damage that he can dish out if they can lock down their target.
And it's going to take a Sanity's Eclipse as well.
Bottom, Khalnayak did choose to go in. He's now going to get tagged with Thunderstrike. They have the glimpse if they want to commit, but Khalnayak is level 7 in this lane versus the level 5 Weaver and a level 3 Disruptor. This is such an easy kill for him if any of them overcommits.
Yeah, I mean, just right now, Khalnayak could have blinked in and brought down Opa with the AWP of Venom stick charges, even the max
if screen. Rival chases this, he's dead.
Yeah.
Khalnayak could just blink, scream, wave and he's done for. Top though, looks like they've again zoned them out entirely and started doing damage on the tier 1 tower. A tombstone plays further behind as well, and Khans is low on HP.
Dire structures are fortified.
Defending his tombstone and everything he's got.
Tower is under attack.
This is such a dirty lane, but it's working.
Yeah.
Yakshas. Going out some new meta stuff here. The top three on the net worth board are all on the side of Yakshas. They're having a fantastic early game.
It is still only 1,000 in terms of net
worth. Oh, rival. Is he gonna die here? He did force out that time lapse, and Khalnayak does have the Sonic Wave still available.
I think Khalnayak is just gonna go back in.
He's got no blink for 6 seconds though.
Cut off.
I mean, rival has to be really careful here.
Yeah, he's probably gonna go down if Khalnayak chooses to. Oh, rival, he shouldn't have shown himself there.
Yeah, he's Sonic Wave pops the stick charges, does have the Sukuchi, but the screams. Well, he doesn't even need it.
Meanwhile,
he gets
top
the
lane, they got a kill. Disruption goes in and kills down BP, while Punk can't really offer any support without that tombstone. So it's still a 2-for-1 trade across the map because the Visage seemed to drop as well.
Yeah.
Dire's bottom,
I think,
tower
a Crystal Maiden for a Visage. You're absolutely okay with that if you're the Yakshas. And look at this, the top tier one bought down to less than half HP. Opa hanging nearby. Sherdils, they're looking shaky in this early game. Not sure how they recover.
Pop, a little low on mana though, so this is when rival can sort of start to claw his way back into this lane. Do what he can on Khalnayak, but I like what Khalnayak's doing, man. He's not hesitating to use the blink defensively.
Yeah.
Many Queen of Pain players will just think, oh, you know what, the tower's so close, I might as well just walk back. But Khalnayak takes no chances. He just blinks back immediately. He's got himself a Soul Ring. That's a little more sustenance in the lane, but up top, looks like we could see another fight breaking out. There's that Mystic Snake. Oh god, Disruption walks forward, but the Tombstone is right in the center of the frame. This is such a bad spot for them to be fighting versus the Yakshas. A Tombstone spawns the zombie apocalypse in their faces. And Sherdils, I don't know if they got scared with the heroes or with Punk just hollering back at them, but it seems to have worked because they've just backed the hell away. That's next level mind games, guys. Unfortunately, for those of you watching online, you can't watch what's happening on the stage, but the moment they decided to right-click Punk, he just screamed at the top of his voice and everyone on the side of Sherdils just panicked. I'm pretty certain they could have killed off the Undying and then backed away there.
They could have. I mean, Khan's really underestimating the power of the Soul Assumption. I mean, with this low cooldown, you can throw it out more than once. And that should secure a kill. But yeah, Sherdils has just been playing this early game passive. They've given up a couple of kills, they got some themselves. They're not really winning the lanes though. All the cores on the side of the Yakshas are doing really well for themselves. They're sitting atop the network charts.
Yeah.
And if you take a look at the Vivo, supposed to be one of the key cores on the side of the Sherdils, he's rather poor at this point.
Top. They've got that tier 1 tower taken apart, and Acrid's the one to claim the money for it. This is going to be a fairly quick linkage sphere coming out.
Sitting at 2,000 gold. This is ridiculous.
This is really not the way Sherdils wanted to start this game. The only silver lining that they have going for them is that Slaughter is close to his blink dagger. And if they score a kill here on VP, it could indeed come out quickly enough. Mamacita, no sanity eclipse available. That's going to be Appa claiming the kill on the Slaughter, delaying his blink dagger further and zoning out both Opa and Mamacita. Things couldn't be worse here.
Punk has finally got in the groove of things inside the game and outside of it. Really enjoying himself, and the Yakshas, they're working with a phenomenal lead early on.
VP.
So, of all the games we've seen on 7.07, no team in the early game has managed to pick up a lead of more than 3,000 gold. The only team that managed to rack up a lead of 3,000 within the 10 to 15 minute mark was Na'Vi yesterday versus Empire. I mean, so far the Yakshas, they're doing well, but look at this, rival. He does have the time lapse. He's been baiting out the Sonic Wave, but at what cost? Acrid and VP just waiting for him patiently, exactly knowing where he would time lapse back to bring him down.
You baited. They not only did they get the kill, they put his time lapse on cooldown now as well. While it may not have been entirely intentional, it actually works out for the best for them. When the Weaver respawns, he's still going to be susceptible for another 30 seconds. And that means that Acrid and Co. can get some damage done in this tier 1 on the bottom. Oh, Opa! Walking past a masterfully placed ward here. They have done their homework coming into this game. I mean, you and I both know what Punk has been up to. We've invited him for games in the middle of the night. He chooses not to join us in our pub games. Instead, sitting and watching pro international tier Dota, learning from the best, learning from the greatest. And now he's brought a blend of that into this game versus Sherdils today. Fantastic warding, fantastic map movements, and overall, just very crisp Dota coming out from Yakshas.
What did Rival do there? Just time-lapse into the midst of them. VP can catch him. He does have the Frostbite. Does have the mana as well, but they're going to show a little restraint and not die behind the tier 1 so close to the enemy shrine.
And now again, the time-lapse is down for about a minute. Tinker, so, he's got the Boots of Travels online as
well. He's got the Boots of Travels. He's queued up the Blink as well as the Kaya.
Now, at this point, the game is pretty straightforward here for Yakshas. You push with 4, you use the Tinker to defend the lane that's being pushed in for you. And when necessary, the Tinker joins you in the push as well.
I guess I get a feeling of what the Sherdils are waiting for. And if you take a look at Disruption on this ladder...
He's got his Blink?
Yeah, he's got his Blink. I was just wondering to myself, why would you pick a hero like the Weaver and not fight early on? They do want to fight, but probably only after Disruption picks up his Blink.
I still feel like they need to wait for Opa to get 6 before
yeah,
they get
that's going to be crucial. Who's picking the Doom? Have they bought the Doom? I don't know. Either way, they need to pick that up. I possibly guess they just give up this tier 1. It's not a much value in terms of map control. They're just going to dilly-dally around it, probably try and find Disruptor 6, but the aim is to give up this tier 1 without any casualties, wait for the Disruptor to hit 6, and maybe then pop a smoke.
Scans are going to tag him on the side. They have an observer ward placed down there as well. There was an attempt to deward, but smart warding again, not putting it in the common spots, putting it in a spot that would give you enough intel to try and make plays happen. They did get a kill earlier.
They see Khans. Look at this. Static Storm manages to catch Khalnaic. Disruption with the crush. He's caught Punk. Punk screamed but then held his voice back for he was caught in the crush. And with the amplified damage upon him, they could run him down. They got vision. While elsewhere, Khans manages to bring down VP all by himself. Khalnaic forced to blink back. Mamacita brings down Punk. They moved for seconds. It's accurate with the amplified damage upon him. But the Sonic Wave, along with the scream, eliminates Disruption. But Acrid will fall. Khans manages to bring him down. It's a double kill for Khans, and Sherdils, just like that, find their footing in this game.
That was way too close for comfort for them. They got tagged by a three-man Sonic Wave over there. It wasn't a level 2 Sonic Wave. If it was, that was it. It would have been a triple kill for Khalnaic right there, but they survived by the skin of their teeth, come out of the gates, all guns blazing, finding themselves the kill on the ever-so-crucial Medusa, delaying a Link in Sphere by a bit. And defending their tier 1 tower.
Yeah.
Big victories across the map there, across the bottom lane for Sherdils, but they're not out of dangerous waters just yet. The lead is still in favor of Yakshas in terms of gold. However, the EXP graph tells a different story.
Yeah, if I'm not mistaken, the gold graph hasn't updated just yet. Oh, it did. Okay. There's a 4K lead in favor of the Yakshas. It's now 2000 in favor of the Sherdils. Key fight coming in for them, Disruption picking up that early blink, making all the difference in the team fights and Khans as well as the OD with that amplified damage doing a whole lot of work.
I mean, see what Mamacita has up his sleeves. He's gone for the 4 stuff as his first item of choice, so that's a way to deal with that Acrid Stone Gaze setting him in the face. Turn around, run the hell away and come back when the fight is in a more secure location for you. But they'll get that tier 1 tower nonetheless. Now the question is, are they going to get any more with it? Mamacita?
Do they have vision? Yes, they do. They caught VP, caught him in the kinetic field. Mamacita is just going to pound away on him. They astral as well to cancel the freezing fields. And they've got detection for good measure to get the D-Wash. VP will surely fall. Acrid comes in, not sure he should be there. Acrid and Punk trying to look for the fight. He drops the tombstone. Punk really pushing his limits there. A quick force up from Mamacita to run away. But Opa with the static storm, he did catch Khalnaic. Khalnaic forced the blink away on the backline. Stinker, he's joined the party, the heat-seeking missile, along with the Mystic Snake, doing some real work on the Slada. But Sherdils is going to run back to the shrine, but Khalnaic changed and gives away his killing spree. All of that for a Slada. I'm not really sure who's screaming, but I think that's a victory for the Sherdils.
You bet it is. That's a dead Queen of Pain in exchange for a Slada. Two down, not just the co-op, it was actually the Crystal Maiden that dropped earlier as well. That Slada kill went over to the Tinker from range. I'm not sure if he even got EXP for it, by the way, but he does manage to get away safely. Mm-hmm. Tinker, his onslaught isn't being stopped though, and that's still going to prove to be a problem if and when Sherdils decides to go higher ground. The basic tenets of this game still remain in place. We talked about how Sherdils don't have a natural pipe of inside carrier. However, they seem to be overcoming that with Visage killing over the Defiance. They don't really have... they do have ways to take the buildings, but for that, Sherdils are going to need an Aghanim Scepter on that Visage. But top disruption, he's found DP by himself here. Khans is going to be joining this party as well. The Mystic Snake is going to tag on a couple of heroes, but the Grave Chain was there to slow them down. There's the Glimpse, pulling DP a little closer back towards them, where they'll finish him off. No amount of Marchbands are going to help them deal with this, as disruption is trying to run. The Astral, defensively used to dodge a Sonic Wave, are you kidding me? And then he blinks out to safety. Sick plays coming out from Sherdils, securing themselves a quick and clean retreat.
Beautifully done. Very visible that there is some level of communication and comfort between these players. That Astral, Mamacita once again at the right place at the right time, and they're probably just going to shrine up and go once more. DP needs to be a little bit more careful. I mean, he's all by himself deep in the enemy jungle, trying to possibly get a ward down and getting punished for it.
The scoreboard in this game, by the way, has just been ripped apart right now.
Yeah.
It was such a passive game to begin with, just a little bit of aggression shown on the top lane by Yakshas, but suddenly they're going at about a kill a minute with the score sitting at 10-8, just 18 minutes in. And now we're going to see another smoke pop with the DB rune up for grabs in the river. No observer ward scouting on this DB rune either, so Sherdils are going to pick it up on Khans and move towards the middle lane. The Mark spam, they're going to wear off shortly. Disruption, watch for the blink of the crush. Who are they going to focus on? They're going to go in on Punk. The crush is there. And Punk is down without any sort of reprisal coming out from him. They will sacrifice the familiar for it, but that's all they're really going to give up. A familiar for a kill on the Undying as they back away quick and clean.
Yeah, and this is all time and space for both Khans as well as Rival to find some recovery. Khans has picked up his Perseverance. He's got enough gold for the ultimate out. And 22 to 23 minutes for Lincoln Sphere is not too shabby a timing, I mean, considering the laning phase that he had.
Yeah.
It's not that they're at the risk of losing a game because the Weaver's picking up his Lincoln Sphere at the 22-minute mark or whatever it may be. But yeah. Yakshas, they do realize that something was working for them when they were grouping up. They're trying to recreate Dyer's this magic once more.
Loving what Mamacita has done, by the way. He chose to pick up the hood for himself as well, so...
Yeah.
More magic resistance coming out. The Tinker's efficacy is being reduced quite significantly. But, I mean, it's not going to help him in the late game when they use the suspect for fun. Right now, she's hitting like a little girl, but...
Dyer's middle
I think
tower
eventually they're
going
to need to start thinking a bit more late game.
Rival as well as Disruption just prepping on the bottom lane for the Tinker to TP. It's Khalnayak instead who's moving across with an Orchid. Well, I mean, he's inching closer and closer to his Orchid.
Watch for the blink initiation. They could kill off Khalnayak with just the Weaver and the Slada here. Enough physical damage if it does connect here with the Amp as well as the Swarm. They've tagged him. They know which direction he blinked in as well. Khalnayak is just pressing all of his buttons. Rival takes the kill and time lapses it off as well. That is just salt into his wounds.
Yeah, neatly done there by Rival. And Appa comes back to defend. I mean, Appa has to be careful. If he is by any chance out of position, Disruption could just catch him once more. A lot of gold going into the pockets of Rival for that kill, and that's nearly his Lincoln Sphere complete. I mean, what was once a huge wave of momentum based on that aggressive try lane coming out from the Yakshas has all of a sudden died out. They're playing for the late game here.
Look at this though. BP right next to Disruption. I think he should have seen him now. He definitely sees him now.
But yeah, the crush is there. Rival could join in. This could bait out a couple of TPs. VP has the corrosive haze upon him, swaps the phasing field. It is a little bit of damage. Rival, I mean, he's being controlled, but the static storm is there. It catches a bunch of them, and one of them is the Tinker. They could move on for sloppy seconds. They managed to bring down Appa. His killing spree taken away, and Punk will fall as well. Beautifully done by the Sherdils. They lose nothing, and they get a whole lot of kills. Khalnayak trying to find something on the retreat. Disruption caught in the trees, has to blink, can blink away if he wants to.
He wants to fight, man.
He's actually manning up. I'm not really sure what for. The kinetic field is there, but Swap could just blink over it. They have vision of the Queen of Pain, and they're going to get away. Mamacita joins his team.
They got the Tinker, though.
Yeah,
that's such a crucial kill. That's also a Midas on Mamacita. I don't know if he had it earlier on or if he just picked it up.
No, he just picked it up. I guess the first usage of his Midas was in the bottom lane. He moved towards the creep wave and just picked up a quick creep.
Well,
22 minute Midas. I mean, Mamacita's got items that keep him relevant at this point in the game, and he wants a Midas hopefully scale as the game goes later.
Yeah, but I mean, most of the Midas is
they've got Punk. Punk has gone silent. He's dropped the 2 though. He's got a little bit of HP with that DK stack. A defensive Astral. Suddenly, Punk lets out a scream. Mamacita cornered, drops the Sanity's Eclipse, gets the kill, but Appa finds Mamacita in return. Acrid with the Stone Gaze trying to run them down. But we mentioned this during the draft. Where is the catch? Where is the lockdown? The rest of the Sherdils just run away.
That was a bit of a throw coming out from Mamacita.
Yeah,
I think Punk got inside of his head. Why else would he go four-staffing in like that to right-click versus the undying of all heroes when his teammates were so far behind? Without the crush, the Slaughter crush, you have no way to deal with that undying. And even with it, when a laser blind connects on you, there's nothing that the OD is really bringing to
the table. I mean, the crush was on the Crystal Maiden. Oh, look at this. They've gone again. They want accurate glimpse into the Static Storm. Controlled, focused by Rival, as well as Disruption. Now, the corrosive ace comes out. A moment too late. Punk TP's in. He's being hunted down by the familiars as well as the Soul Assumption. Punk ends up falling to the familiars and the Soul Assumption. It's a killing spree on Khan. That Rival is in the trees. He sees Akron nearby. Apa's TP cancelled with that glimpse, and there's nowhere to run, nowhere to hide. Rival will bring down Appa, while Akron as well as VP, they're just watching, they're spectating, because there is no lockdown on the side of the Yakshas.
Time and time again, it's the same old story. The only real lockdown that they have is the Crystal Maiden. If the Crystal Maiden's out on the front lines, who's going to be the one protecting her? Akron, Atos, Khan's going in further as well. They have most lows coming up from VP, holding them in position. A Soul Assumption, a weak one from Khan's, means that VP is going to back away as well. They've just been trying so desperately to take this tier 1 tower down, but they're not getting it. But elsewhere, they get a kill on Khalnayak.
They kill the Queen of Pain as well as the Tinker multiple times. I think Queen of Pain has picked up her Orchid, but they're doing some serious work here on the side of Sherdils. Killing these cores time and time again. Khan's even picking up a flashy new item in the form of the Aedos. Mamacita's got the Hurricane Pack complete. Inching closer towards the Blink.
They're super tanky right now. Two Hoods of Defiance, Aedos, Hurricane Pike, lots of strength items across the board.
Yeah, and just like that, it's Sherdils now with the net worth. They swung the net worth back in their favor. Punk hasn't picked up a new item in the
Radiant's
field.
Top tower
also
is under attack.
Carried away, been participating in all these fights and not finding too much. He's got the Maelstrom complete that's going to help accelerate his farm in the mid game. They're not going to be able to do it.
Punk's got himself no tombstone now. This
is Punk is going in. The Aedos is like crush on the VP.
What was the early game strategy that helped
I'm going to take all my questions in this general direction, and you guys can
his earlier game
and give him a chance.
Disruptor.
I will.
We saw that the static storms were not always the point. And I don't blame him. He can't.
How will anyone know we're doing it wrong?
But this time around, the static storms are securing key kills from the Thinker as well as the Swap, and now they're on the hunt for more. Actually, he's cut that link in paper, but Opa can trigger it with ease.
They've got an ADOS as well.
They see him on the side, but there's still no way they catch him.
May I Medusa, Undying?
Lots of space created. We had a choice about whether to go for the
and Tinker was made.
Or whether to go for Acrid somewhere here. We decided on the co-op.
And Queen of Pain was Niche. Alone.
Crush. That basically
did he farm well?
I think Khan is trying to solo.
Any good inventory anyone make over?
I mean, the Eidos from Bane.
And Nail Stop.
Very well done.
So they're starting off, I think Yakshas played well, and then you come back and say that the Sherdils have come back.
It's a hard game to be a Crystal Maiden, and you pretty much just got to stay behind your nose at this point if you want to stay alive.
What
they've been praying for.
Because Undying Devourer
has
farmed a lot.
And slowly.
Outworld Devourer.
Gaining a lot of map control.
Devourer.
Devourer.
Lockdown, you can't afford to lack detection. You got multiples on lockdown? Okay, maybe not having detection is acceptable.
Devourer.
You have no lockdown,
who's saying that
expect to get away. Look at this, your rival trying to run away, disrupt the bottom of the side. And Lang just running in, the Sony is committed. Appa wants to do something, spam.
I have an intelligent hero.
Look at this, Opa on the side, waiting patiently. Waiting for disruption to go in for the notch, and Lang giving chase to rival. But once again,
entire,
no means to trigger his link-ins, and no means to follow that up and lock
down
in place.
Has, like, Kutka?
Just to bail over there, no one actually ends up dying inside of Sherdils, but Visage continues to farm towards his Aghanim Scepter on top. Got almost enough money for two components.
4 points of health. 4 points of intelligence.
I mean, this is
and it is passive.
Big hurdle on the ground.
Yeah, next time you're gonna watch this whole game, okay?
They have. They're really struggling to hold down the Weaver, or heck, even the Slugger.
I think Sherdils are the ones that are in the driver's seat right now, and all they've got to do is group up and take that Aegis soon. They got the lineup to take him down as well. But they're choosing to go late game. You can already see two Midases coming out, one on the Slara and one on the Mamacita. Now they find Khalnayam. Status Storm will be completed without hesitation for him. This is death. 50 seconds, no clock. Take Roshan, should be the call. Okay, you can see some fairly desperate stuff coming out from his boys. He's trying to push and give momentum to modern, however, they're not going to get much done here. Rosh is going to drop for free. Everything seems to be going in Sherdils' favor this game.
Yep. So it's something that I've noticed earlier on. I mean, since
so we're bang
the
in the middle of Dota 2, and we have our experts here to decode
first,
this fantastical chaos that's going on.
Amar,
Mikhail,
really
please help me understand.
12, 15 minutes. That's what's going on.
And
very few
teams are playing. The start of the game,
that could not have. I mean, this could not be worse for Tinker. Solo kill by Khan on the Visage. Down his Aghanim Scepter being picked up. That's 45 seconds without Tinker. 45 seconds where an Aegis push could be mounted here.
Sherdils is going to push up to the bottom as well.
Rival,
he has the blight.
They sent three rows in the top lane, which was Queen of Pain.
Some pressure on the Tier 2.
Punk's Undying is just starting to fall off in such a big way right now. That tombstone is just free gold for Khans to pick up next.
Punk
hit
level 10 and not pick up his talent.
Yep, exactly.
Plus health,
plus 8 health regen is good. Even 100 cups is decent.
Yeah, I agree. I mean, maybe the one point in Soul
Radiant's
is
bottom tower faces
okay.
A stiff wind.
They actually end up with
Radiant.
Sorry about that.
Fortification can
but
save
find
them.
Radiant's
bottom tower is
under attack. This is just the universe around. He's even feeling the familiars over there.
But look at these shells. They're getting
a few
on the other half.
I don't know, man. I still think that's okay for Yakshas. Acrid is just getting beastly at this point. He's going for the Mantis style, which I'm not happy.
No, he can try late game, right?
You
can try late game, right?
You do, but die.
God games.
That is, I mean, now you're just asking for
Mantis
here, please. We expect to dodge glimpses.
Dire's top tower is about to take the plunge.
Okay, smoke coming
out.
I've got the Aces on the Weaver, if I'm not mistaken, and the Desolator as well.
Yeah.
A kill on Acrid is very achievable for Sherdils, but can they find him? They're on the hunt, they're moving towards the middle of the map.
Three heroes in the top lane.
Dire have the spyglass at hand.
He's hanging back for the time
and
being.
The three
Arbor's
heroes
had a rough game.
Oh, what are you doing?
Radiant's middle tower can't handle this deluge.
I'm trying to fucking remember Outworld Devourer.
I'm not sure why they didn't commit to that, because the prop was still on the top side of the map. And
yeah.
Well, they didn't know
so
that.
They
she
sent about 3 heroes in the top lane and attacked Viva out there.
Nothing accomplished by the smoke
from
either sides, yeah.
The 3 heroes which they sent were.
They put BKB as well.
Blinked BKB.
Can I take that knife?
Huge at this point.
Dire's top tower is about to take the plunge.
So, as Amar was saying,
I
don't think so, man. I mean, the hex is the way to go for.
Okay.
How's the Appa looking for him? Progress. He's
got
the axe.
Lighting on this guy's axe. That's still farming music.
Dire's bottom tower won't last long.
That They're just wasting this Aegis right now.
Yeah.
Smart
money.
They use the Aegis to farm some more, which is something they could have done without the Aegis anyway.
But why were they
singing
he's probably gonna end up using the Aegis without any food.
Oh, so they wanna take him out right
in the beginning?
Yeah, you don't wanna be walking about like this and just giving up an Aegis without accomplishing any objectives.
And are they succeeding?
Level,
they did.
How long
the
do the Aegis is taken
on
the game by
Medusa? And
he's about 4 minutes now.
Wow.
The Aegis should be taken away right
now.
Whoa,
and you think that the Sherdils couldn't.
Unless I got that wrong,
this would
be another. Yeah.
They did see through it.
Anyway,
they tried to
smoke once again.
Okay.
What KT is, I don't really know.
Okay.
But on the other hand, they have the Sherdils had their captain. The Indian leader of the team, Mamacita.
Yeah.
Outworld Devourer.
Okay.
He's farmed a lot of
the
smoke high.
Really?
Yeah,
he's got
up
his
smoke
really
himself.
Strong inventory.
Okay.
So he's holding down the fort for the team.
So strong inventory, ka matlab kya hota hai? What can you achieve with a strong inventory?
So, as in when you farm gold, kill
creeps,
kill heroes and get more gold on your side.
Look at this, Kalnayak. It's all by himself. Blinks into the trees, the swarm is there to tag him.
Glimpse?
Disruption going. Second delay, Opa didn't come into the glimpse and the smoke was wasted.
I checked it.
And possibly
need to
farm too much.
Mamacita's gonna continue to stick around in the middle lane with his four stuff and BKB. I don't think jumping in an Acrid is the right choice either, but you've got to do something now.
Outworld Devourer.
The Aegis is no longer available on rivals.
Outworld Devourer to
slow down once again. He's
got
to
hold it. Outworld Devourer to Acrid. He's got a good idea, but Mamacita goes in.
He has a BKB.
There's a tombstone on the ground, disruption with the crush, but the storm is doing a whole lot of work. And Acrid healed up, and the soldier just turns around, mans up against disruption, and brings him down. They try to bring down the Medusa, and they might end up losing more. Opa pops the Shadow Amulet, hopes to stay alive, nothing to hold him in place. He's going to get a quick four star from Mamacita.
He has a glimpse.
He has a glimpse, but does he have vision though? Yeah.
Oh!
Strange stuff coming.
Do you
out.
Want to
disruption?
The first game that
App has
a
fight coming
on
disruption. Jumps in on one side, doesn't tag Medusa with the stun, and ends
up
getting taken down. While Mamacita was forced to go in by himself. I'm not even sure why Mamacita chose to engage there.
Yeah,
bottom tower couldn't withstand the tide.
Mamacita trying to work for the team.
You got Sidus in the back, right?
Oh, he farmed it.
Dire's middle tower is under attack.
Bleak dagger on cooldown for a while. While he did get a lot of items, I don't think they're the most efficient items because the hood and the BKB seem counterproductive to each other, and at the same time, the 4 staff and the well, the Hurricane Pack and the Blink, they're only really adding
to his mobility,
not giving him any sort of firepower.
Alright, okay.
I think his job at this point is more than just to take away the mana from the
blue side. By killing creeps and heroes.
Yeah.
You can buy off stuff, right? Which is what we call, you put the items in the inventory. Which builds either
what would you have like to see?
So together, these guys want their carry heroes to build or
going
farm
for
as much as they can.
I
so that they can
probably would advocate a hex on him.
Attack and cause major damage to
farm. I mean, it's not like he needs to go to some back, right?
Yeah. 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 Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
This will
give me the idea that he's not
who's very heavy
on the thing. He needs to be able to get out of the
damage.
A soldier's fortune.
Like literally nuke.
Yeah, four people in one.
A stray lightning drop tagging Lara, which prevented him from making it and starting the fight a little earlier on. Multiple occasions that happened, Lara decided to go back out time and again. Problem is, while Kaplan does build the front line meat shield that they need him to be, he's not really doing as much damage as they need him to.
They shouldn't, but they have Medusa, but
he's not accurate. Dire's middle tower is under pressure.
This hero can play late game and can do a lot of damage. So, they're not totally out of it, but they have Medusa to fail them.
Dire's middle tower is under pressure.
The Yakshas have the upper hand, obviously, which is based on the fact that the bot potatoes have a very good set of a whole of potatoes and everything, and that's
the chicken. Alright guys, this is...
Soak up a little bit more damage. But I don't know.
Yeah.
You think she goes to something like Deadlifts and then KP or straight up that.
I think an MKB would be nice, but you know for the fact that the Reaper's
On that note, we're going to take a short break on the other side of this break. You will find out what happens at the end of DOTA 2. We're going to hear the Sherdils or the Yakshas.
Can we kill Roshan?
Regeneration! Fighting after they've got the Roshan taken apart.
By who?
By Yakshas.
They find themselves for regeneration, and that makes his life wicked about easier. No base trip for him. He's going for the blade mail himself, by the way, so he's choosing to be that meat shield alongside that Medusa. And now it's going to be hard because Medusa is going to have the
He got it.
You know, apart from staying alive, she's also going to be playing hard now.
So,
Butterfly is going to ensure that.
Okay.
Sneak. What do you go for as your final talent of Medusa? Split shot target or modifiers for split shot?
So, plus 7 split shot target just helps you.
Welcome back after the break. You are watching Ucypher. We are at the last leg of the game. And I just saw that in this game of Dota 2, Roshan got defeated again.
Yes.
Who was that by?
The first time by the Sherdils, they got the Aegis of Immortals. And on the second time, the Yakshas managed to get the cheese, which kind of gets your health and mana.
You can see how scared Appa is right now, just staying with his
team. How do you kill Roshan and not get the Aegis?
The first time you get Aegis, second time you get cheese. Obviously, why would you just drop the cheese? You get Aegis and cheese?
Yeah.
Okay.
Think Yakshas
is going to fight us. Yeah, Aegis and cheese they got. Sorry, take care.
Highground versus Tinkers, hard.
Dire's top tower is about to take the plunge.
Invisibility.
Dire's top tower is under attack.
That goes separate for a while now, but it's not been done yet.
Killing spree!
TV on Punk, and there's a Hex coming out as well. That's going to be one more kill this time. That's two down immediately. Khalnayak now in trouble. Blinks himself out of there. Acrid loses most of his health.
Health
and
mana is
going to be 8% of the base. What's with the boss?
Health and mana is going
to be. The timing though. They've caught Tinker in a static storm and a kinetic field. That's going to be the death of the Tinker without a doubt and rival. He still has the BKB if he wants to pop it, because Tinker can turn and hex him. However, he's still got the Lincoln Sphere to work with. I think if you're right, you just focus on the Tinker first, and then you turn your attention over to either Khalnayak or Akron.
Yeah, I mean, Khalnayak doesn't have something to pay. Just focus the Tinker
bring
him down. Who's
going to be Akron? It's Akron, so you take out Tinker first, then you focus on Akron and take him down twice.
They're good to go. Let's see how he gets out of this one.
Yeah, so
why
are
you standing up a lot?
Why
are
you standing up a lot? Why are you standing up a lot?
Because it's all by himself. He triggered Lincoln's fear. Oh, but look for the glimpse. The glimpse of cooldown. But look at this. I just couldn't run it down. Yeah, that's nice. Really helping him take down this
chunk.
And it's even already a buyback on a buyback on time. Back off. Focus the deal.
Why is Khan spinning up his
Radiant's middle tower can't handle this. Radiant's middle tower has fallen.
That's 300 gold they've got over the active again.
But they put on a buyback.
That was basically a 5-man wipe for Sherdils. They got all every single hero, the Aegis keeping Medusa alive technically. Also a buyback force on the top, like you pointed out. And Jade's tower. Big victory for Sherdils. They'll come back to the next fight with a lot more gold and a few more new items as well. I think it's time that Mamacita is going to ditch that hood and get himself a bigger item. It's going to be the Shiver's Guard for him this time.
A gift from the Tempest of Battle.
Eva, on the other hand, what's he going to be picking up? Lathan it is. Alright, the entire Orchid now complete. One more way to trigger a Lincoln Sphere.
Oh, well, that's a great counter for this guy.
He doesn't care, man. He's not holding on to the buyback at all.
Yeah.
In fact, he's playing no boots as well.
Sanity?
He did choose to go for the Shibuji move.
Sanity?
I was meant to have this.
Although, I do feel like an MKB or something would be ideal choice.
I don't know.
Akrid has a Manta and a Lincoln, so what's the Bloodthorn really going to do to him?
I'm hoping to at least pop that Lincoln.
I mean, the DB
is standing for
the commander side. Short break that we had, the tables have turned, and the Sherdils are now leading in Dota 2.
In which case, of course, the Bloodhound is a much better.
Is unpredictable, and how? Guys, how does this happen so quickly?
Well, a lot of team fights that happen, the Sherdils have done this, which means that they've got more XP, more gold for themselves. And you can look at the scorecard, it reflects that the Sherdils are way higher than you.
And now the
Sherdils
have taken the lead.
We have changed positions out here. Weavers gone down to the bottom lane.
Okay.
And getting the pistol lead at the bottom lane. Attacked by Z. So they have made some good position changes.
So the Sherdils are now online. Made a sacrifice. He was alone in the bottom lane. He told the Weaver, okay, come to my lane. I will go and hold down the fort against three heroes.
Wow. Got himself that level, could that level 25 talent online as well.
Mean in the meantime.
Yeah.
Jesus, and he achieved that.
I mean, he right clicks a tower and it just
so
melts at
this
point.
Drama attached to it. But tell me, Roshan,
he can't afford
twice
to bring them next to the Medusa.
How many times is he allowed
split
to
shot will just
killed
rip a hole straight.
Every time you kill Roshan, he respawns in about 12 minutes. But the best part is, once you kill him at the start, he drops Aegis. That's like a resurrection. So if you die, you have that, you come back.
12,000, not too much of an upgrade, but
yeah, like,
it's still Sherdils who are winning the crucial fights as and when it does come into their hands. The thing that's going
to
be really
good 8 to 12 will
happen.
Yeah.
With that refresher up though, yeah.
Yeah.
I'm enjoying it.
Listen, so when I ask
Roshan,
then like
really
give him the
show
of what Roshan is.
Because if you're not dishing out the damage or... So at least you're going to be taking away a lot of the mana as well.
Yeah. So, the first Buriyal, after a little bit of stolen intelligence, took away 70%. Couple that with a refresher shard, and you're pretty much taking away all the mana. Maybe a couple of starters.
And I believe Roshan died twice so far. How is that possible?
So Roshan is basically
If that happens again, then what happens?
I mean, the Tinker's great, don't get me wrong.
Again, get the Aegis of the model.
Okay.
It's
and
so hard for even a creep way to approach with the Medusa nearby.
Cheese.
He's also gone through much damage, so that's obviously with talent, but he's gonna have to be the defense. Doing on Hex Lock coming out here on the Blissey. Super tanky. Mamacita comes in, turns with a Hex of his own. Goes straight for the Tinker. Big trouble. Tinker actually turns around and gets the kill with the laser, and now they're gonna counter Hex Mamacita once again. He'll just pop his PZP and finish what he started. The Acrid. Heavy chase here. The Swarm is gonna connect on the Mamacita. Goes in deep and goes for the Acrid. The Acrid as well. Now the off lane thrown down. Acrid in trouble. Taking a beating from the laser. Takes a beating from Mamacita as well and ends up going down. Now Bunk is here by himself. What can Bunk do? It's a double kill from buyback. Mamacita survives to evolve. No buyback.
Is this something that comes with experience or is he just flying with it?
No, I think
but
it's experience.
Huge victory for them.
He knows that if someone
is just going to march down the lane, bear
out
the familiar.
So
yeah, they're going to force a buyback. Apple buys back. Active can buy back as well.
The final point, you only need to know when you play the game.
Okay.
Or it's just
you can't just go online and see Arjun.
Another defense.
Okay, I'm lucky enough to have the experts decode. Crazy game,
less than
but if you guys want to catch me diving, head over to newsports.in. We're going to go back into the game, but don't leave my side,
please.
I didn't want to know what all these
guys are doing. Putting an Aegis upon the Weaver and pushing up with the high ground. All these fights he's been going solo, but without an Aegis. He's chosen to go for the strategic.
मेरे को भी हाल नहीं आ रहा है मैं मैंने खुद ही बोला कि गो ऑनलाइन और आई डोंट नो स्क्रीम
ऑफ यूट्यूबर स्क्रीम ऑफ पेन इज देयर 1.5 सेकंड अरे नेक्स्ट टाइम ओ डू यू गो फॉर द लिंक इन दिस गेम द
डबल लिंक इन दिस गेम
आई डोंट नो डू यू गो फॉर द लिंक इन दिस गेम डस इट इवन स्टैक आई नेवर एक्चुअली ट्राइड इट वन सेकंड हो गया आई डोंट नो डू यू गो फॉर द लिंक इन दिस गेम डस इट
इवन स्टैक आई नेवर एक्चुअली ट्राइड इट वन सेकंड हो गया आई डोंट नो डू यू गो फॉर द लिंक इन दिस गेम डस इट इवन स्टैक आई नेवर एक्चुअली ट्राइड इट वन सेकंड हो गया आई डोंट नो डू यू गो फॉर द लिंक इन दिस गेम डस इट इवन स्टैक आई नेवर एक्चुअली ट्राइड इट वन सेकंड हो गया आई डोंट नो डू यू गो फॉर द लिंक इन दिस गेम डस इट इवन स्टैक आई नेवर एक्चुअली ट्राइड इट वन सेकंड हो गया आई डोंट नो डू यू गो फॉर द लिंक इन दिस गेम डस इट इवन स्टैक आई नेवर एक्चुअली ट्राइड इट वन सेकंड हो गया आई डोंट नो डू यू गो फॉर
द लिंक इन दिस गेम डस इट इवन स्टैक
आई नेवर एक्चुअली ट्राइड इट वन सेकंड हो गया आई डोंट नो डू यू गो फॉर द लिंक इन दिस गेम डस
इट इवन स्टैक आई नेवर एक्चुअली ट्राइड इट वन सेकंड
हो गया आई डोंट नो डू यू गो फॉर द लिंक इन दिस गेम डस इट
इवन स्टैक आई नेवर एक्चुअली ट्राइड इट वन सेकंड हो गया आई डोंट नो डू यू गो फॉर द लिंक इन दिस गेम डस इट इवन स्टैक आई नेवर एक्चुअली ट्राइड इट वन सेकंड हो गया आई डोंट नो डू यू गो फॉर द लिंक इन दिस गेम डस इट इवन स्टैक आई नेवर एक्चुअली ट्राइड इट वन सेकंड हो गया आई डोंट नो डू यू गो फॉर द लिंक इन दिस गेम डस इट इवन स्टैक आई नेवर एक्चुअली ट्राइड
इट वन सेकंड हो गया आई डोंट नो डू यू गो फॉर द लिंक इन दिस गेम डस इट इवन स्टैक
आई नेवर एक्चुअली ट्राइड इट वन सेकंड हो गया आई डोंट नो डू यू गो
फॉर द लिंक इन दिस गेम डस इट इवन स्टैक आई नेवर एक्चुअली ट्राइड इट वन सेकंड हो गया आई डोंट नो
डू यू गो फॉर द लिंक इन दिस गेम डस इट इवन स्टैक आई नेवर एक्चुअली ट्राइड इट वन
सेकंड हो गया आई डोंट नो डू यू गो फॉर द लिंक इन दिस गेम डस इट इवन
स्टैक आई नेवर एक्चुअली ट्राइड इट वन सेकंड
हो गया आई डोंट नो डू यू गो फॉर द लिंक इन दिस गेम डस इट इवन स्टैक आई नेवर एक्चुअली ट्राइड इट वन सेकंड हो गया आई डोंट नो डू यू गो फॉर द लिंक इन दिस गेम
डस इट इवन स्टैक आई नेवर
एक्चुअली ट्राइड इट
वन सेकंड हो गया आई डोंट नो डू यू गो फॉर द लिंक इन दिस गेम डस इट इवन स्टैक आई नेवर एक्चुअली ट्राइड इट वन सेकंड हो गया आई डोंट नो डू यू गो फॉर द लिंक इन दिस गेम डस इट इवन स्टैक आई नेवर एक्चुअली ट्राइड इट वन सेकंड हो गया आई डोंट नो डू यू गो फॉर द लिंक इन दिस गेम डस इट इवन स्टैक आई नेवर एक्चुअली ट्राइड इट वन सेकंड हो गया आई
डोंट नो डू यू गो फॉर द
लिंक इन दिस गेम डस इट इवन स्टैक आई नेवर एक्चुअली ट्राइड इट वन सेकंड हो गया आई डोंट नो डू यू गो फॉर द लिंक इन दिस गेम डस इट इवन स्टैक आई नेवर एक्चुअली
ट्राइड इट वन सेकंड हो गया आई डोंट
नो डू यू गो फॉर द लिंक इन दिस गेम डस इट इवन स्टैक आई नेवर एक्चुअली ट्राइड इट वन सेकंड हो गया आई डोंट नो डू यू गो फॉर द लिंक इन दिस गेम डस इट इवन
स्टैक आई नेवर एक्चुअली ट्राइड इट वन सेकंड हो गया आई डोंट नो डू यू गो
फॉर द लिंक इन दिस गेम डस इट इवन स्टैक आई नेवर एक्चुअली ट्राइड
इट वन सेकंड हो गया
आई डोंट नो डू यू गो फॉर द लिंक इन दिस गेम डस इट इवन स्टैक आई नेवर एक्चुअली ट्राइड इट वन सेकंड हो गया आई डोंट
नो डू यू गो फॉर द लिंक इन दिस गेम डस इट इवन स्टैक आई नेवर एक्चुअली ट्राइड इट वन सेकंड हो गया आई डोंट नो डू यू गो फॉर द लिंक इन दिस गेम डस इट इवन स्टैक आई नेवर एक्चुअली ट्राइड इट वन सेकंड हो गया आई डोंट नो डू
यू गो फॉर द लिंक इन दिस
गेम डस इट इवन स्टैक आई नेवर एक्चुअली ट्राइड इट वन सेकंड हो गया आई डोंट नो डू
यू गो फॉर द लिंक इन दिस गेम डस इट इवन स्टैक आई नेवर एक्चुअली ट्राइड इट वन सेकंड हो गया आई डोंट नो डू यू गो फॉर द लिंक इन दिस गेम डस इट इवन स्टैक आई नेवर एक्चुअली ट्राइड इट वन सेकंड हो गया आई डोंट नो डू
यू गो फॉर द लिंक इन दिस गेम डस इट इवन स्टैक
आई नेवर एक्चुअली ट्राइड इट वन सेकंड हो गया आई डोंट नो डू यू गो फॉर द लिंक
इन दिस गेम डस इट इवन स्टैक
आई नेवर एक्चुअली ट्राइड इट वन सेकंड हो गया आई डोंट नो डू
यू गो फॉर द लिंक इन दिस गेम
डस इट इवन स्टैक आई नेवर एक्चुअली ट्राइड इट वन सेकंड हो गया आई डोंट नो डू यू गो फॉर द लिंक
इन दिस गेम डस इट इवन स्टैक आई नेवर एक्चुअली ट्राइड इट वन सेकंड हो गया आई डोंट नो डू यू गो फॉर द लिंक इन दिस गेम
डस इट इवन स्टैक आई नेवर एक्चुअली ट्राइड इट वन सेकंड हो गया आई डोंट नो डू यू गो फॉर द लिंक इन दिस गेम डस इट इवन स्टैक आई नेवर एक्चुअली ट्राइड इट वन सेकंड हो गया आई डोंट नो डू यू गो फॉर द लिंक इन दिस गेम डस इट इवन स्टैक आई नेवर एक्चुअली ट्राइड इट वन सेकंड हो गया
आई डोंट नो डू यू गो फॉर द लिंक इन दिस गेम डस इट इवन स्टैक आई नेवर एक्चुअली ट्राइड इट वन सेकंड हो गया आई डोंट नो डू यू गो फॉर द लिंक इन दिस गेम डस इट इवन स्टैक आई नेवर एक्चुअली ट्राइड इट वन सेकंड हो गया आई डोंट नो डू यू गो फॉर द लिंक इन दिस गेम डस इट
इवन स्टैक आई नेवर
एक्चुअली ट्राइड इट वन सेकंड हो गया आई डोंट नो डू यू गो फॉर
द लिंक इन दिस गेम डस इट इवन स्टैक आई नेवर एक्चुअली ट्राइड इट वन सेकंड हो गया आई डोंट नो डू यू गो फॉर द लिंक इन दिस गेम डस इट इवन
स्टैक आई नेवर एक्चुअली ट्राइड इट
वन सेकंड हो गया आई डोंट नो डू यू गो फॉर द लिंक इन दिस गेम डस इट इवन स्टैक आई नेवर एक्चुअली ट्राइड इट वन सेकंड हो गया आई डोंट नो डू यू गो फॉर द लिंक इन दिस गेम डस इट इवन स्टैक आई नेवर एक्चुअली ट्राइड इट वन सेकंड हो गया आई डोंट नो डू यू गो फॉर द लिंक इन दिस गेम डस इट इवन
स्टैक आई नेवर एक्चुअली ट्राइड इट वन सेकंड हो गया आई डोंट नो डू यू गो फॉर द लिंक इन दिस गेम डस इट इवन स्टैक आई नेवर एक्चुअली ट्राइड इट वन सेकंड हो गया आई डोंट नो डू यू गो फॉर द लिंक इन दिस गेम डस इट इवन स्टैक आई नेवर एक्चुअली ट्राइड इट वन सेकंड हो गया आई डोंट नो डू यू गो फॉर द लिंक इन दिस गेम डस इट इवन स्टैक आई नेवर एक्चुअली ट्राइड इट वन सेकंड हो गया आई डोंट नो डू यू गो फॉर द लिंक इन दिस गेम डस इट इवन स्टैक आई नेवर एक्चुअली ट्राइड इट वन सेकंड हो गया आई डोंट नो डू यू गो फॉर द लिंक इन दिस गेम डस इट इवन स्टैक आई नेवर एक्चुअली ट्राइड इट वन सेकंड हो गया आई डोंट नो डू यू गो फॉर द लिंक इन दिस गेम डस इट इवन स्टैक आई नेवर एक्चुअली ट्राइड इट वन सेकंड हो गया आई डोंट नो डू यू गो फॉर द लिंक इन दिस गेम डस इट इवन स्टैक आई नेवर एक्चुअली ट्राइड इट वन सेकंड हो गया आई डोंट नो डू यू गो फॉर द लिंक
इन दिस गेम डस इट इवन स्टैक आई नेवर एक्चुअली ट्राइड इट वन सेकंड हो गया आई डोंट नो डू यू गो फॉर द लिंक इन दिस गेम डस इट इवन स्टैक आई नेवर एक्चुअली ट्राइड इट वन सेकंड हो गया आई डोंट नो डू यू गो फॉर द लिंक इन दिस गेम डस इट इवन स्टैक आई नेवर एक्चुअली ट्राइड इट वन सेकंड हो गया आई डोंट नो डू यू गो फॉर द लिंक इन दिस गेम डस इट इवन स्टैक आई नेवर एक्चुअली ट्राइड इट वन सेकंड हो गया आई डोंट नो डू यू गो फॉर द लिंक इन दिस गेम डस इट इवन स्टैक आई नेवर एक्चुअली ट्राइड इट वन सेकंड हो गया आई डोंट नो डू यू गो फॉर द लिंक इन दिस गेम डस इट इवन स्टैक आई नेवर एक्चुअली ट्राइड इट वन सेकंड हो गया आई डोंट नो डू यू गो फॉ
not being spammed. Rival just running through the march. Mamacita's had enough. He's gone in. Hex under the Crystal Maiden. Not sure if this is going to be enough. VP pushed up off the Ghost Scepter and run away. Immediate defensive Astral. Sherdils are looking for the openings here.
But the problem is Mamacita, while he did open up space
Rival,
there.
Rival's had enough. He's gone in. Time lapse is out. Opa, what was that? Glimpse! Style Storm, he's found the Tinker, but will he even get the chance to use the Refresher Orb? That's no good at all. Harper just turns it away, gets the kill and blinks out of there. Hex coming out from Mamacita. He's trying to focus the Undying. He should be getting Punk. Punk pops his Blade Mail, but there's no way he survives. The Tier 3 falls, while elsewhere, Khan's up no good either. Where is Khan's actually?
Not a clue, but he died.
Okay, Khan's ended up falling. They're trying to find them. Disruption with the Crush on a Kalnaik. And the Refresher Shard, yet to see it being used efficiently in any game just yet at the Ucypher League. Kalnaik just blinking in aggressively. He's got no real lockdown. Needs to be careful. Disruption could just turn around. Rival moves forward, pops his Lincolns, controls him with the Orchid, and this could be a death on Kalnaik. Acrid trying to kill the bug, gets punished with the Crush from Disruption. Amplified damage, pops his Lincolns spear. Acrid just pops his Manta, pops the Stone Gaze, and mans up. Not sure Kalnaik ended up falling. Apa though, he's on the hunt. He's trying to bring down Mamacita. Not sure he can do it by himself.
Fight's not over though, on the top side, Disruption came back in for sloppy seconds and gets taken apart. Rival was here to try and make something happen, but now he's going to be forced to TP himself out as well. OD, not a good idea for Mamacita to keep split pushing this bottom lane either. The Stinker could show up at a moment's notice, Sperma Hex him and just finish him off.
They get the tier 3, they lose the Aegis.
You know, so Mamacita's got himself so much intelligence right now that the perk should be kicking in as well. Yeah, he's got 30.1% magic resistance coming out. And that's without a Hood of Defiance picked up.
Okay.
Radiant's bottom shrine is under attack.
Well, that's actually 30.1 magic resistance over and above, so he's got a total of 47% magic resistance. A lot of the magic damage is essentially just being half at this point. Khan's in a world
Khan's
of trouble
to be
here.
Careful.
He's not going to survive.
I mean, Appa, Glimmer Cape upon him, should probably start out with the X, but Acrid with the Scar, he's slowing him down. Appa goes in with the Hex. Opa,
what?
Static Storm. He manages to catch the Tinker. Tinker looking to blink away, but Opa being focused and brought down. Appa with the Hex once more. Acrid brings down Disruption. Excuse me, brings down the Disruptor. But Shrival comes in from the back, brings down Appa. Time lapses out of there. Mamacita though. Mamacita being focused, brought down along with Punk and Acrid. And Acrid, he's had enough. He's just manning up. Appa still alive somehow through all of this. They lose the Weaver, they lose everyone other than the Visage, and they're missing buyback as well.
That was a buyback coming out from the Tinker, but such a worthy one. Acrid, man, the damage he's pumping out can no longer be ignored. He went for the split shot target, so he just wiped out everything around him. And let's not forget the Mjolnir procs all along the way as well.
Goes in with the Crush, four stops immediately, Opa jumps in, he's got the Static Storm, it's on to Acrid, but where's the follow-up? Acrid just turns around and brings down the Disruptor, Slada on the run, Lotus up upon him, the Tier 3 under siege, how do Sherdils hold on? It's 3v5, and more than anything, it's 3 versus the Medusa, Acrid, he's just moving on to Tier 4, along with Kalnaik, the Yakshas have had enough. Khan's just trying his best, throws out the Atos. Acrid just shrugs it off with his Manta style. Disruption probably has to go in, crushes the Undying, crushes the Crystal Maiden. But at this point, they don't mean anything because Acrid, he's focusing Mamacita, who's been forced to pop his BKB and just run away. The Tier 4 under siege. Punk has found his voice. The rest of Yakshas have as well.
How do you
stop Yakshas? How do defend that road? Mamacita goes in. A Hex might secure the kill onto Punk, but Punk is still alive. Mamacita's fallen. It's pointless at this point. A Hex onto the Slada.
They
the
left their keyboard. They left their goddamn keyboard.
They left the computer. They left the keyboard and the mouse. And this is one of the most convincing and devastating victories I've seen in the Ucypher League.
Forgot! Forgot!